Good morning, everybody. So I and Vimashina are here to share and teach nonviolent communication. And this session is going to be very interactive because nonviolent communication is a practical tool and a practical process where we can really practice and experience it. So we are going to have an interactive session. To conduct an interactive session, we want your support. It means we want your inputs and sharing also. So we will be giving mics. So you can just, because of the social distancing, so we are unable to have a setup that where we can do group activities and all. So because of that, we have some challenges. However, we want your support to interact with us to conduct an interactive session. So we are going to start this session with a role play. So I and Vimashina are going to do a role play and then we will ask your comments and feedback.
Please observe it carefully. Ramanusha, today is the deadline to submit the assignment. You haven't given your 2 pages. I even, you know, leave a message to you yesterday. You're so irresponsible, Ramanusha. I'm tired of this.
Vimashina, you would have called me and told me no.
I left a message.
You are a friend of mine. Why couldn't you call me and tell me? I would have done no. Why you are blaming me now? Because you know that I was studying for the other exam also.
This is a group assignment, Ramanusha. I can't spoon feed everyone at the group. Please.
You're always misunderstanding me. Okay, I'm sorry that I could not do that, but you would have told me no.
Okay, your sorry doesn't mean anything to me now. We have to submit it today, okay? Send me the 2 pages.
Okay, so this is an example of a communication. So we would like to hear your comments. What do you think about this type of communication? We would like to hear a few voices so we can give the mic.
Yeah. Feel free to say it in any languages. Is it a common thing? Happens all the time? Huh? Assignment, group assignment. Fights with friends? Fights at home? Okay. Anybody experience this? Can you raise your hands? Or you want to share?
We would like to hear some few voices, at least 2-3 voices. Your comment about this role play, this communication. There's no right and wrong answers, just for the interaction.
Kamathi deyak kiyanda. Yaluwoth ekka randu wenakota, gedara ayath ekka randu wenakota, apo me wage dewal hamadaama wenawa athine. Yeah? Feel free. If you're not speaking, we can't do this session. Okay, I'll go behind.
Bima, there's a raised hand.
Yes, of course. That remind me some exam situation that I'm facing these days, and I that character is kindly familiar, one of my day scholars. And
which character?
No, like your character, because it is exam, because these days we are doing research, and our group consists of 2 cadets and 2 day scholars, and by tomorrow, day after tomorrow, we need to submit pitching research templates, as I know. So each and every day, like yesterday I got a mail, it says like, I'm really disappointed about you. That's what it exactly said. And this is not an individual work, this is a group work. It was highlighted and bold. And like excessive situation, so due to the time and like, with everything, it's like very little time that I can focus. So they are always taking the meetings and ask us to be like online and stay, yes, blah, blah. So I said always, yeah, just decide what you can and just tell me what you need to be done. So then I'll just submit it by the day. So I just have no time to join with your meetings or listen to the recordings. So yeah, you are like just herself. That's it.
Thank you for your sharing. So we would like to hear at least one more voice, maybe to have some gender balance. One voice from
Day Scholar. Who's the Day Scholar acted my role? Okay, we are not pointing. Anybody here? Volunteer? There's no right or wrong answers. Just say whether you've experienced it or not.
Or any comment about a role play. Even if you are not experienced, that's okay. There are going to be more and more sharing. Then only we can have this workshop interesting and alive.
So this is something that I've been going through the past few days, as he mentioned. It's really stressful, and I think I could understand your character more in that. So even now, I met one of my friends and I was speaking about one, and I was asking him, take the lead and do this thing at least. So yeah, I can understand that it's stressful and I could relate to your character. Thank you.
Thank you. Ramanusha.
Okay. So we pause this role play right now, and at the, or maybe towards the end of this session, we'll redo the role play. So after learning nonviolent communication, how we can redo this communication in more connecting way, we'll see that. Okay, so today we are going to share about nonviolent communication. So before we understand nonviolent communication, I have a question for you all. That is, what is communication? So it's a general question, because we are going to introduce nonviolent communication. So I would like to ask a question. What is communication? Again, there is no right and wrong answers, and you can tell the answers wherever you learned about communication. What do you understand by communication? Or any elements of communication?
So I really don't know the correct answer. As I said, this is just my opinion. So I believe communication for me is the ability to express, but most importantly, in an understandable way by both the mutual parties. So that's how I take communication as. Thank you.
Okay. So it is, communication is an ability to express. Any other sharing? Any other answers? So generally, what do you mean by communication? Any answers? I would like to hear at least one more answer, then I can go ahead.
We thought people here are so talkative, but it's pin drop silence. One from this side. I can see expression, oh God, again. We're going to do this throughout the 2 hours. You have to talk.
I hope at the end of the session, we'll be more connected and more ease. As it is a starting, you might feel uncomfortable. And unfortunately, okay. This setup is also a little challenging. Sorry for that.
Well, communication can be said is a transaction between group or individuals by messaging or verbally, we can say.
Okay, so verbally or through, you know, in the
social media.
Media through text. Okay, thank you. So I can give a simple definition or like explanation for communication. Usually in communication, there will be one receiver or like group of receivers or group of senders. So that was in one sharing that it's an ability to express. Not only it is an ability to express, but also ability to receive. So in one communication between two people or more than two people, there's an exchange of message. So the message can be feelings, expressions, opinions, can be whatever. And then even though that is an ability to express, but we don't know whether whether we express in a way that the other person can understand, or we express in a way that both people don't, or both group of people do not understand each other. For me, communication is a very, very complicated process, because we can teach people you need to, you know, communicate in a proper way or a nice way, so you need to communicate in a good way. But when the emotions arise beyond our control, we communicate in a way that we might hurt people, or that might disconnect each other. So even though we, like I am studying and sharing and trying to practice in nonviolent communication for 15 years, having said that, it is still complicated and it is still challenging, because lots of emotions arise and human beings are dynamic. When human beings are dynamic, we cannot have a kind of a, how to say, 1+1=2 communication. So communication can be creative, and communication is so dynamic as well as challenging, because we always intend to communicate to have understanding and clarity and effectiveness, but most of the time it is challengeable for us to communicate in an effective manner, and that is okay also. For me, there is no right and wrong way of communication. We all are trying to connect, but sometimes not in an effective manner due to many other reasons. So now I would like to introduce nonviolent communication. Okay, the word is. I don't know whether you can read. It's okay. So can you see two hearts here? Okay, so in the normal communication, we talked about exchanging messages, but the intention of nonviolent communication is to build heart-to-heart connection between people. It's not only merely exchanging information, but also we try to understand each other. We express from our heart, which is an authentic communication. We express our authenticity, our reality, our truth to other person. And we also trying to empathize other person, or we empathically receive other person. So in this way, through empathy and authenticity, we are trying to build a heart-to-heart connection in nonviolent communication. So the purpose of nonviolent communication is to build heart-to-heart connection. Because when we ask people what is the purpose of nonviolent communication, people say it is to reduce violence, or it is to communicate in a good way, or it is not to hurt people. But the real intent, or to resolve problems, of course you can resolve problems, but before that we need to build heart-to-heart connection. That heart-to-heart connection might be building trust, or might be building understanding, or empathy. So that heart-to-heart connection can happen not only by receiving empathically, but also expressing our truth, expressing our expressing what is alive in us. So the intention of nonviolent communication here, we try our best to express honestly and also receive other person empathically. So I would like to give a very, very brief history of nonviolent communication. So you can see the picture of Dr. Marshall B. Rosenberg. So he's the scholar who created this process of nonviolent communication. So Dr. Marshall B. Rosenberg, he was a Jew, and he was in USA, and he experienced violence in his life. So in his childhood, he was really thinking why human beings are choosing violence. So he was very sad about that, because he experienced violence and riots in his life. And then he was researching why human beings are choosing violence. And then he witnessed something else also, that his uncle was looking after his grandma, a sick grandma. So looking after a sick person is a very challenging thing. But still, that uncle was doing that with joyfully. He can see a sir. He saw a smile in his face. So human beings are capable of being compassionate also. So he was researching why human beings are choosing violence, and why sometimes human beings are so kind even in a difficult situation. So he was doing his research, and he studied psychology, and he became a clinical psychologist, and then he studied comparative religions, and then he created this process of nonviolent communication with the intention of, as I said earlier, to build heart-to-heart connection between people, because he believed in the process that it is not we are teaching nonviolent communication to improve you. It is not that we are teaching nonviolent communication to correct you or to make you good people, but we are teaching nonviolent communication, which is already in your heart. That is our nature, core nature, compassion. It is emphasized in many religions also, that human beings have the capacity. It's not that all human beings are compassionate right now, but all the human beings have the potential and capacity to be compassionate. So this process of nonviolent communication is helping to reveal our compassionate nature. So it is not to correct you, it is not to improve you, it is bringing you as you are with your core real nature. So I can give a very small example for that. Marshall said this example, like he saw like children feeding ducks. So when children feeding ducks, the parents do not tell them to feed ducks, but the children joyfully feed the ducks. So in our countries, you can see the children feed cats and dogs. Even the cost of biting them, they sometimes feed food for the cats and dogs. Not the parents, not because the parents told, because naturally human beings are compassionate. Even sometimes you can see children cry when they see adults crying. How that came? Who taught them empathy? Who taught them compassion? No, it is our core nature. So we can see these simple examples that human beings have a natural tendency towards compassion. So the process is all about bringing the compassionate nature. And there are two animals you can see. One is giraffe and one is jackal. I'm not going to explain much about this. So giraffe, we symbolize giraffe for people who speak nonviolent communication, because in the living animals, giraffes have the largest hearts, and also giraffe has a long neck, so the giraffes can see, can have a broad view, can understand the needs of others and understand the needs of themselves. And also, giraffes are like, they are like vegetarians, and giraffes are like, looks like a calm animal. At the same time, giraffes are also very powerful. Giraffes can even attack an elephant. So giraffes means, because people think, people who speak nonviolent communication or who people practice nonviolence are weak. Actually not. People who practice nonviolent communication or people who practice nonviolence are the most courageous people. So giraffe is a courageous animal also. So that's what we symbolize. Not only have the big heart, but also very courageous. And then again, this jackal. So poor animal. So it's not like giraffe is good and jackal is bad. It's not like this is like for the training purpose and learning purpose we are kind of symbolizing. So jackals is a communication of manipulation, judgmental, blaming, labeling, criticizing, demanding. Those type of language. So it's only the difference between like a type of languages, giraffe language and jackal language. It is not to divide people. You are jackal people, you are giraffe people. Not like that. We all have the capacity to be compassionate. We all giraffes. Sometimes we speak jackal language. That's it. Okay. So one of the team principles of nonviolent communication is connection before solution. So that's what I told, the main intention of nonviolent communication is connection. So I have a question. You can give a very quick answer. If you hate someone, or if you are very angry with someone, what will you do? Quick answer. If you hate someone or you are very angry with someone, what will you do? Quick answer. You You can say it in one or two sentences.
Even without the mic.
Even without the mic. Sorry? Blaming, okay.
What else?
What else? Blaming is one answer.
Stop talking.
Stop talking.
Talk
stop talking with that person, but not stopping with about that person, maybe. So we do gossiping, so we blame, or we run away. What I do normally when I'm angry or hate person, I also run away from that person. So normally we have a tendency, if we have a very disconnection or angry and hatred, what we do, we try our best to run away and form our group against that person. So normally conflicts happen like that. So here we are bringing a new solution or new way. When you hate someone, when you are angry with someone, there is a signal we are getting, we can go for a connection with that person. So if there are a lot of problems with someone, then we can think of a connection with that person. Because sometimes we feel very unsafe, we feel very uncomfortable. So these days people use this word toxic people and all. In NVC, we don't use this word toxic people. There are no toxic people. All are compassionate people. So we say these are toxic people. I want to be away with this person and all. We run away. So we use that tactic. But in NVC, we are proposing a different tactic. You go for connection with that person. That is what we call connection before solution. Before you solve the problem, you try to connect with that person. Of course, it's very challenging, but that is what we are proposing. So the key principle of nonviolent communication is to spend time and energy on building connection with people, which can bring trust and ease and can help to resolve differences and problems. So we might have differences and problems, but if we spend a lot of energy on connection and building trust, then we can easily solve the problem. So this is one of the main themes of nonviolent communication. Okay. So Marshall developed this process based on four components: observation, feelings, needs, request. So we are going to learn these steps one by one. So we try our best to explain these four components through activities or maybe only explanation, depends on time. So these four components, as I mentioned earlier, these four components are helping us to bring our compassionate nature or connecting nature back. So he created these four components, imagining that these four components will help us to communicate in a more connecting way. So I stop here and I invite Vimashana to share the session on observation. But before that, if you have any questions or comments.
Any questions? Okay. So as Ramanusha said, NVC, we use this term for nonviolent communication. Nonviolence, as a concept, it has, taught in all main religions in the world. But here we talk about NVC, nonviolent communication. It's a process of four steps. That is what we're gonna learn today. So observation, feelings, needs, and request. The first one is observation. So let's do a small activity here, and we want all of you to participate. Okay, can you see these two pictures? Okay, so I'll give you 3 minutes. Okay, I'll give you 5 minutes. Just have a good look, okay? Look at these two pictures and write 2 sentences of what you see in this picture. 2 sentences of one picture. What do you see? If you can just say it, you don't have to write, but if you want to write, you can write also. Two sentences of what you see. This is the reason we ask you to sit there.
Who's ready? I think enough time to have a look. Can you tell me your two sentences?
I see two contrasting livelihoods of people. I see one party who may be living a better life than the other, and but they both seem to be happy, in my opinion. Whereas I see another party who may be close to the age of the party on the left, but they still have to work hard for their living. And it's basically two different sides of people, although we may not notice the one on the right and notice the one on the left more.
Thank you. This side, who's ready? Two sentences.
So we are seeing two different pictures. In the first picture, we are seeing someone's living a life that is far better than the one on the right. And it seems that they are living a very easy life, and both of them look happy together. And the picture on the right shows that she's almost the same age, but working twice as hard or more than that. And I think most of the time, people will ignore the one on the right and focus more on the one on the left.
Thank you. Anyone? These are what you see. Anyone else who has a different sort of sentences of what you see here?
Yes, two contrasting pictures. Well, the first sentence is very contrastive because the first picture depicts a happy couple, you know, celebrating some kind of festival, while the second picture depicts a woman like struggling to live. But if we take the second sentence, I think this is what life is common, you know, some people have the ability to live happily while some struggle to live. So the two pictures in common depicts what life is.
Okay. I have a question for you. What did I ask you to do? To write to or say what you see in this picture, right? So three of you shared. Is that what you see or is that what you think? What did you say? Like those sentences? Are those what you see or what you think? Is it same or different? It's different, right? We see something and we think that is what we see. So these are two different things. So observation is what we see, hear, or, you know, touch. But we learn to do rather than doing observation, we do what? We do judgments, right? We see something, we think about, you know, okay, I've seen this, okay, this is what it is, and I have my own opinion about it. Okay, can you just try saying what you really see in this picture? Just try. Can you explain this as how you seeing it from a lens of a camera? Can you try? Can we have the two pictures back? What do you see in this picture? Try saying. Do you know whether the camera knows whether are there a couple or not? Camera dannoda? Meya couple ekakda kiyala? Na ne? We see two people. One person is holding something and the other person is just trying to take something from it, and you can see there's some flowers hanging. Is that what you see, right? What about the other picture? A person is sitting and collect, like just looking at this way, and her hands are on top of stones. You can see two baskets full of stones. Is that what you see, right? Okay, what did we say then? When you say it like this, it's like harinaya wage ne nikan amuwen wage. You feel like it's not nice thing to say, so you decorate it. Happy couple, the living standards, you know, she's struggling to live, these are like they're celebrating life, 40 years, 50 years of marriage. Can camera see it? No, right? So observation is the first step. You say what you really see and hear, not your judgments. Began decoration dala malwal ellala ewa neme. You say what you really see, and it's like actually explaining something that you see through a lens of a camera. Camera can't see, right? Whether they are married, whether they are happy or sad, camera can't see that. So, but it's very difficult to say observations, because as kids also we learn to say what we think, not what we see. What happened in the scenario, the role play we did? You're always like that. So whenever we say you're always, you're often, like you've never come to, you know, us, whenever you use those terms, it's what you're saying is a judgment. It's not a observation. So when you say observation, you tell exactly what you saw or exactly what you hear. You know, Amal said to Kamal that Neeta came at 5 o'clock today. Something like that. Okay, so you go to house 5 o'clock, you see your younger brother or sister watching TV. Tuesday you are going, Monday you saw this. Tuesday also you are seeing, 5 o'clock when you reach home, that person is watching TV. Okay, Wednesday also you see the same thing. Okay, the next day you want to watch the match. It's like, hama velawama TV eke menna me denna mata remote eka. So whenever you say that, you're always watching TV. Has he done it in other days? You saw only 3 days, right? Maybe he just started watching a cartoon that started on Monday. But based on those 3 days, you make a judgment. But if you say, I saw when I came on Monday, you were watching TV. When I came on Tuesday, you were watching TV.
And yesterday I saw you were watching TV. Can I please watch the match today? So there, you're not blaming that person. You are able to build a connection between that person while saying the observation. Because observation is something that both the parties can agree. So there will be, okay, imagine there will be like two people walking inside this room, just holding hands. Right? What can be possible? You can say they are dating. You can say all sort of things, hundreds of things, right? But what you really saw is two people walking in, maybe you can say what they're wearing, holding hands. That is what you saw, right? You can't just say like, everyone saw the same thing, but all of you have different stories about it. I've seen these two in the canteen, I see these two in the No Limit. Maybe they are not dating, okay? They're just helping, something like that, okay? So observation is something we all can agree on. So this is the first step of NVC. Understanding the difference between observation and judgment. Now when I say this, you can, you know, all these lights, okay? Is what I'm doing is observation or judgment? You can just check on you. Whenever you say something to someone, you can actually check with you, am I telling an observation or an evaluation or a judgment? Because it's easy to evaluate, because we are so used to it. So learning NVC is actually unlearning these things, okay? It's not that you learn it today and you start from, you know, evening onwards, okay, I'll only do observation. No, that's not going to happen. As Ramanusha said, she's practicing NVC for nearly 15 years. Even it's challenging. But having the awareness of, okay, this is an evaluation, this is an observation. Having that understanding really helps us to connect with the other person. Any questions? Sorry, we are rushing. Any questions? If not, we can go to the next step. Ramanusha?
Okay. Do you remember the, because in one of the slides I showed four hearts. So do you remember the second component or second heart? So, cannot hear. Feelings. Okay. So you have observed clearly. Okay. So the next component in our process is feelings. Okay. So do you think all human beings have feelings? Yes. Any objection? You all agree that all human beings have feelings. Okay. So can you say me, what is feeling? Can you explain what is feeling? Any answers?
Eva, mehema prasiddhi kiyanna ba.
Okay. So actually, for me, actually, in these four components, feelings is one of my favorites. At the same time, feeling is one of the difficult components for me to teach, because feelings is something to be experienced, not to teach. So it's very difficult for me also to explain what is feelings. Yeah. But I can share feelings happen at heart level, or feelings happen in our body. What are the mood, what we experience within our heart, what we can experience in our body, those are feelings. Sometimes we have thoughts. Thoughts are like head level. So if I'm connecting with my feelings right now, I'm bored, can be a feeling. But if I'm saying, I'm feeling like going out of this auditorium, that is a thought. But if you try to connect with your feeling, because that is thought, oh, I don't know how long this session will go, I don't know when I will get lunch, or, you know, those are thoughts. But if it is feelings, or I'm concerned, I'm confused, I'm bored, I'm feeling agitated. So these are feelings. So feelings are at heart level, where we can embody that, where you feel within yourself. It's like a mood. Feelings also, you can say that feelings which can be captured in the emojis, you know, the smileys. But thoughts, something like an expression. I don't know why this happened, what I'm going to do, all this, like this mental drama. Those are thoughts. Sometimes we mix the feelings and thoughts together. Sometimes we say, oh, I feel like I'm manipulated. I feel like I'm cornered. Those are also thoughts. Because I'm cornered means like we are giving a definition, it's kind of an analysis, like kind of a, it's a thought. But if I'm connecting with my heart, I'm feeling lonely, I'm feeling sad. That, you can sense that. You can, body can catch that. But if I'm saying I'm cornered, I'm ignored, I'm rejected, or these people are always like that, I don't know what is going to happen, why this happened to me. Those are the thoughts, the running thoughts. So feelings are our inner experience and emotions which are connected to needs, which we will learn a little later. Feelings are not our thoughts or opinions. Feelings are the expression of met and unmet needs. So what is the point of learning about feelings? Okay, all human beings have feelings. So what? We can simply ignore feelings. So when the feelings come, normally we do two things. Can you guess? When the feeling comes, we do two reactions sometimes. Not two, there are many, but normally. When the feelings come, imagine a lot of sadness coming, a lot of pain coming. What do you do? Huh? What do? Cry?
Cry. Yeah.
Okay. Any other answer? Any other?
Having kiyana wa high-end kiyanne.
High-end kiyano na ehenawa. What do you do? Normally, we are taught when the feelings arise, we try to suppress the feelings. No, I'm okay, I'm not sad. No, we try to suppress. Even anger, we suppress. Or we react very aggressively. We kind of shout and blame and, you know, even become violent. Sometimes we kind of react aggressively, or we really put bottle up within ourselves. So we really don't know what we do about these feelings. Sometimes even I think, oh, why this sadness is coming, can't I get escape from these feelings? Of course we like happy feelings and vibrant feelings, yes, but this sad, anger, pain, depression and all, it's very difficult. So what are the use of these feelings? We are not taught to get in touch with our feelings. There are a lot of benefits when we get in touch with our feelings. Because we say that feelings are our life-directing natural mechanism. These feelings are a natural mechanism within our body, within our system, emotional system, that guide us in our life, which we are not aware about it. So I can give example for some physical feelings. Let's say you all are tired. What is the signal? Physically you are so tired. What is the signal? What is the unmet need here if you are tired? Let's say you all are tired now. What do you want? Sleep. Okay, sleep, rest, sometime fun.
Some are already having that.
So these are very natural mechanisms. So those are not lying to us. Our feelings are like our messengers. Sometimes, let's say we are having a, you know, some burning sensation in our tummy or some ache. It means we want food or some energy or nutrition. So feelings, like when I'm explaining this physical sensation, you can easily connect. Okay, when I'm like, when my body is tired or like I feel lethargic, and then I might need a sleep or I might need a food or I might need some energy. But when it comes to heartbroken, heavy-hearted, sad, angry, those are also same. They are also messengers of something is not fulfilled in ourselves. Something like an alarm clock. So we can learn further in the need session about these feelings. What are these feelings indicating? If I'm sad, means rather than ignoring that sad, rather than aggressively expressing that sadness, we can connect with our sad. We can sit with our sad, sadness, and see what is missing. What are my needs are not fulfilled? What can I do to in order to meet my need? So feelings, connecting with the feelings, also kind of an art. Feel, if you really observe feelings, feelings can come and go. Sometime when the feeling comes, we don't know what to do. So we get like something like a holding on a hot pot, and like we are like, we don't know what to do. Sometimes we just break it, or sometimes holding it for a long time, it hurts. But feelings, rather than reacting to it aggressively or rather than bottling it up, we can serve with a feeling. We can, like a wave. Then the feelings can come and go. For me, one of the greatest things I learned in nonviolent communication, after understanding the needs, after identifying my needs, then only I felt I'm alive. Because if I'm really connecting with my feelings, I feel more alive. And I'm more connected to the life. I'm more connected to myself, and I'm more connected to the people. And another important thing about feelings is that we all have same feelings. There are so many ways we are feeling, there are so many ways we are different from each other. We have so many polarization, we have so many conflicts all over the world. Even with the same family members, we have lots of differences which we are struggling to solve, which we are struggling to coexist. But there are few things like COVID, very universal. Feelings are universal. We all have same feelings. Sometimes it might change, but we, as human beings, we can connect another human being at the feelings level. Needs, all those needs also same. At needs, like in a human needs level also, we can connect to each other. Needs also universal, which you will learn a little later. So the importance of understanding and expressing feelings have a lot of benefits to connect with myself and connect with others, to understand what is missing in me, like that.
And also, adding to that, we have the responsibility for our feelings. But we tend to say, because of your work, I get angry, man. Are we saying that? Because of you, I am really disappointed. We feel anger. We feel frustration. But we are trying to put that responsibility onto someone else. But can we do that? Feelings are ours. Taraha ginti ne karada? Mata. Ek apita wenak kenege pite danna pulwanda? So, responsibility of our feelings belongs to us. And also, as Ramanusha said, either we express it or we suppress it. But we have to really welcome it. We can't say, okay, now I can't get angry. Anger is already there. It's just natural flow, right? Even while sitting here, how many feelings are coming and going? Sleepy, bored, right? Maybe sometimes curiosity. Okay, what's going to happen next? So all these feelings are just coming and going. So it makes us alive. It makes us human, right? Api kena minissu harita hangim podiyak wage. Whenever we ask people about just to even name feelings, we just hear, what? Happiness, sad, anger, fear. Only those four feelings. Is that what all we have? No, right? So there are thousands of emotions, feelings we have. We've shared two or three handouts with you. Have you looked at it? So there's a list of feelings. Just have a look. Right? There are. But it's very important to know our feelings, because that is where we can connect with the other person. As Ramanusha said, you know that you are having that feeling. You get those feelings, and you know the other person also getting those feelings as well. The other person also experience, feel the same as me. That is why feelings are important. And as I said, like, you know, you can't just reject what comes to you. So it's like you're gonna get, you know, out from your house. When you open, there's some stranger standing over there, or someone, you know, just visiting you. Can you shut the door? You can't, right? You have to just welcome that person, maybe offer some tea, and then you say bye, right? So feelings are like that. It comes to you, you have to just welcome it, acknowledge it, and accept it, and let it go. So feelings are like that. It's not that, okay, I can't have these unpleasant feelings. No, it just comes naturally. So the important of feeling is to know your feelings. So I feel it right now. Okay? So you can just have a look. So many of feelings.
So
okay, before we move into the other one, you want to do the activity?
Yeah. Okay. So before that, so we divide feelings into two sets. Once, even in your handouts, you can see that there are two titles. The feelings when our needs are met, and there's another title, feelings when our needs are unmet. So we don't divide feelings as good feelings and bad feelings, or negative feelings or positive feelings. We welcome all feelings. Feelings are feelings. We are not labeling feelings as good feelings and bad feelings. So, but we see some feelings happen because when our needs are met. Let's say we are tired and then we are offered an orange juice, and then we feel like, you know, rejuvenated. And then it means I'm feeling rejuvenated because my need for energy and water is fulfilled. So when the needs are fulfilled, we say happy feelings. You know, tender, warm, safe, excited, interested, stimulated, open, confident, calm, jubilant, happy, lively, glad. So these are the indicators when you're all having this type of happy feelings, or like, you know, more very pleasant feelings, means our needs are fulfilled. And then again, there are sad feelings and angry feelings and confused feelings, means our needs are not fulfilled. So these are the messengers. We don't have to avoid these feelings. So we don't have to get upset about these feelings. We can welcome these feelings. And then we try to connect with that feelings and seeing what are the unmet needs in these feelings. So you have the handouts. So you might need to use these handouts in order to practice nonviolent communication for this session as well as after this session in your life, because we are not having a feelings vocabulary, or we don't have much feeling literacy, because whenever we ask about feelings, people say, okay, happy, sad, fear, angry. But there are so many feelings. Marshall says feelings are like a music come from the symphony museum, music. So there are lots of variation. But if we, for everything, if a boyfriend comes 10 minutes late, also you say depressed, and then one of your close friends also dies, you say depressed. No, when the boyfriend comes 10 minutes late, it's like disappointed. When your close friends died, it's heartbreaking, heavy heart. So feelings differ time to time. For that, we need to have the feelings vocabulary where you can use this list to understand your feelings as well as other person's feelings. So I would like to guide you all through an exercise. It's something like a guided exercise where you are going to do individually. But here, like for more than 1 hour. So I would like to invite you all to stand up and to do some stretching by standing itself. Can you all stand up?
Can all of you see me? Okay. Is it easy to do? Okay. So when you feel bored, practice it. Because it shows how our left and right brains works, coordinate. Okay. Whenever you feel sleepy, you can try this. Thank you. You can sit down.
Okay. So... after this body movement, I imagine that your need for energy is a little bit fulfilled and your body bored might be a little bit disappearing. I hope. I'm not sure. I can guess only. Okay. So now I would like to guide you all through an exercise where I will give instruction and you can follow it. I mostly welcome to do this exercise with closing eyes, so that would be helpful. So I'm going to share a scenario. So where you imagine that you are in that situation and you go through that situation, okay? But what you're going to do is, every time you go through that situation, I pause you and to check the feelings. So sometime you can check in the board or you can just look into the file, or even you can keep on closing eyes and just connect with your feelings, with your own wisdom. Okay, so are you all ready? Ready? Yeah. Okay. So close your eyes. So now imagine today is a day you need to submit your assignment. So you got up at 5 o'clock and came to the college and then submitted the assignment at 11 o'clock a.m. So I pause you to connect your feelings. How are you feeling in this moment? Are you feeling relieved? Are you feeling calm? Are you feeling grateful? Glad? Tired? You can connect with any of the feelings. So now you submitted the assignment at 11 o'clock and then 11 o'clock itself, lecture started and then you got only 1 hour lunch break and the classes ended at 6 o'clock. And I pause here, your feelings. So how are you feeling right now? Tired, quiet, full? fulfilled. You can connect with yourself. Just connect with your body. How are you feeling right now? So now you get into the bus. Regardless of the COVID situation, there's a squeeze in the bus, so many people. You are sweating throughout the mask. How are you feeling? Exhausted, tired, burnout, or curious? Just connect. You don't have to only listen to my words. You can connect whatever the feelings come to you. Now, you go down from the bus, you went to the home, there, things are everywhere. And you went to the kitchen, the unclean dishes, you went to your room, clothes on bed and on the floor. I pause you here. How are you feeling? Annoyed, angry, sad, calm, curious? Just connect with your feelings. Then your brother coming and telling you that I can help you with cleaning. I can arrange this home. And now, pause again. How are you feeling right now? Relieved, connected, loving, annoyed, angry, any feelings? Now, you are getting a call from an unknown number. And the receiver and from the other end, your friend, your school friend came back from UK, and she's telling that I have come to Sri Lanka and I'll come to your home for dinner. So it's such a sweet surprise to get a call from your friend at the same time. House is already messed, how to make dinner. So in this point, how are you feeling? Torn, overwhelmed, or happy, or curious, calm, angry, whatever the feeling, just connect with the feelings. So again, you're getting a call from the same friend. She's telling, no, I'm not coming to dinner to your home. I'll book the dinner in Cinnamon Hotel. So can you come? Can you get a cab and come? So I pause here and connect with your feelings. And then you are ready to go to the dinner at Cinnamon Hotel. So you can connect with the current feeling right now. Happy, content, connected, loving. Oh, jubilant, vibrant, lively, whatever the feelings, or tired. And you can open your eyes and come to this auditorium. So I would like to hear your feedback. How was this exercise? Were you able to connect with your feelings? And what is your learning from this exercise? I would like to hear from the few words because we don't have much time. We need to move on to two more components.
Samaru kata aragene cinnamon nige hiti. Manadi kiyan kemathi? Anything that you want to share? Were you sleeping? Did you feel anything? Just two people, just say what did you feel?
Yeah. Were you able to connect with the feelings, or is it like a disturbance, or you can tell whatever the experience?
Someone who didn't speak.
We would like to have some cooperation, so we'd like to hear 2-3 voices.
Did you feel anything? Okay,
she felt something. May pathe.
Did you feel anything?
Yes.
At the morning, I had to submit the assignment. I get up at 5 o'clock and however submit the assignment at 11 o'clock. At that moment, I feel like I'm okay now, and like I don't have any weights on my shoulders.
So again, sometimes we use the word like I'm okay and I'm not okay. That is the difference we are making. Because okay and not okay is not in feelings. Because anytime we have a feelings, right now, I'm a little bit confused and disappointed. I need some interaction, so I'm feeling a little bit disappointed. So then rather than saying I'm okay or not okay, anytime there might be feelings. So after 2 minutes, I might feel calm. So maybe I might feel nervous or I might feel upset. So it's not we are evaluating, I'm okay, I gave the assignment, I did a good work, not like that. We are connecting with our emotions. Am I relieved? Am I fulfilled? Am I feel lively or happy? Okay, thanks for sharing.
Yes. And also, as you see, we tend to say our thoughts. You know, I felt that there's no weight in my shoulder, right? Those are our thoughts. This is what we, you know, process here. But what you really feel is, you know, you feel relieved because you submit the assignment. So feelings are what you really, you know, experience, your inner emotions. As Ramanusha mentioned, we are not so used to express our feelings. We feel, ammo anita mona hitai danne, feelings kiyanna ba, you know. We think that being vulnerable is a weakness. That's why we don't really express our feelings. But it's very important to know that we feel it and also important of expressing it. Okay, because of the time, we'll rush into the third step. Is it? What is it? Can I hear it loud?
Needs.
Needs. Okay, when you hear the term needs, what comes to you? Food, obviously. The best need in the world. Okay? Food. What else? Sleep. Shelter. Water. So these are like basic needs. You know, you need clothes. Are there any things other than basic needs? Huh? Attention. Need. What else? You need to be understood. You need to be heard, right? You need love. Ane apita nang onne. Emadi na? Na. We all need it. Needs are universal. Why needs are universal? People who live in Sri Lanka, Australia, Canada, Afghanistan, everyone has needs. Apita vitara avashyata thiyenne? No. And avashyata needs are universal. Wherever you live, you need these things. And needs, we can say, needs are essential for our physical, mental, and spiritual well-being. Needs are universal, but how we are fulfilling it, we say strategies are different. You all said food is a need. But what are the ways we are fulfilling it? Someone can eat rice, kottu, paratha, noodles. These are strategies. Even when you're wearing mask, I can see your happiness. Yeah. And attention or acceptance or respect. How are the ways we fulfill these needs? Some people think if I wear a sari, I get a respect. If I have a government job, I'll have a respect. If I have a two-story house, I have respect. I'll get respect. If I draw a car, people will respect me. What is the need? Respect. But there are different ways we fulfill it. Those we call it strategies. So as you can see, we may have different strategies and ideas. However, we share same human needs. And we can't say, based on how you fulfill it, you can't say that is right and wrong. Hari varadi hondai narakai kiyala kiyanna ba. Because avashyata kiyanne vishwiya da. Okay? And every action we do, everything we do is trying to fulfill a need. How? I can see some are just putting their heads like this. What is the need? You need to be comfortable. The comfort is the need. Some just nod their heads. What is it? You understood. So you feeling that that is need, that need is met. So whatever small action we do is trying to fulfill a need. Okay, we're going to do a small activity. Take out your books. Because we all experienced this is last year. You will get a notice today that the whole country is going to be in a lockdown. You won't get anything delivered. Everything will be shut down. Okay? Just make a list of 10 things that you need to be at home or your boarding house, wherever you're going to go this afternoon. Write 10 things that you're going to survive in this 1 month of a lockdown.
And there won't be any online purchase. Yeah.
You can't order anything online.
That's not available.
Yeah. Whole country will be shut down. Okay, right. 10 things you need to stay alive for the month. Anyway. 1 month lockdown, what I need. Ammagen tamai ahanno ne. Ehemada? No, right? Okay, let's have some answers. Would you like to share? Again, I'm going to pass. It's okay. You don't want to? Yeah. I can see long lists. Just 10 things, huh? Can someone share from this side, please? Anyone from this side? You've shared. I can see a list of.
Food, water, medicines, first aids, clothes. That's it.
That's it. For a month. Food, water, first aid, medicine. Anything else?
We can hear from one more person.
Yeah. I saw storybooks. Wi-Fi router. Liyala tibbe wa thamai man kiyanne. Anything else? Please share.
Sanitizer items.
Your list.
I couldn't hear.
Nothing new. Okay. I hope you people survive.
Any other new items?
Yeah.
Can you share? Medicine, food, storybooks, router. What else? Sorry?
Tissues. Okay. Interesting.
So
adara ata wahana kiyotta hawasiri gedirani tissues aranda. Maybe we live in a different country, Amrisha.
One of the things when I think about lockdown, I think about Vim soap. Because I bought Vim soap for 1000 rupees.
Yeah, in the last lockdown, I guess. Yeah. See, okay. Whatever you wrote, it's in the category of basic needs. But that is not the only thing. There are different, like, we have given you a list of needs. As I said earlier, acceptance, love, to be heard, to be seen, respect. All these are also needs, support, intimacy, love. They're all needs. And as we mentioned, it's universal. No matter what ethnicity, religion, caste you belong into, these needs are universal, same to everyone. Okay, any questions? Why it's important to know our needs? What we communicate is our needs. To build the connection between the heart-to-heart connection, we actually communicate our needs. Feelings are like messengers. Whenever you feel a pleasant or unpleasant feeling, that gives you a message of what is your unmet and met need. So that is the core of it. So it's important to know, like when you're feeling sad, disappointed, what is the need that is not being met? So when your friend is not supporting for your group assignment, you get angry, right? You get disappointed. What is the need behind it? What is the need that is not being met? Friendship, support, cooperation. So these are the needs that's not being met. And you feel angry, disappointed. Okay, with the time, we'll go into the next one. So when we have to, when we need the other person's support to fulfill our needs, we use this next step, request. Amanusha.
Okay, so I don't want to overdose you all, but we are trying to introduce the four components and try to give one more demonstration and see how we can learn and practice nonviolent communication. So far we have learned three components: observation, feelings, needs. So observation, we learn to differentiate observation from judgment, analysis, comparison. And in observation, we see what we express, what we see, what we hear, and smell and taste, what we get from the five organs. And observations are the facts, where we communicate the facts rather than our interpretations or judgment. So when we express our facts, then there's more chance for understanding and connection, and less chance for disconnection or kind of, defending. Other person might not defend themselves. So, and then we are trying to connect the feelings of myself and other person. And then we are trying to understand the needs of myself and other person. And then after understanding the needs, the last part is the request, which we say the action part. Because after identifying the needs that we all want, love, understanding, to be heard, trust, nutrition, energy, rest, hope, peace, freedom. So these needs are, there are universal needs, and we try to understand each other through these needs. So once we have identified the needs, in order to meet that needs, there are so many strategies. So already Vimashana explained that if we are hungry and if we want food, and there are so many choices. You can eat noodles, you can eat rice and curry, or you can eat boiled vegetables, or you can eat pittu or paratha. So like that, to meet one need, like you need cooperation and support to complete the assignment. And there are so many ways that you can get support. From X, you can get support. From Y, you can get support. From X, you can get the support in a different ways. So when we identify the action, we can make a request rather than the demand. So requests are distinct from demands that we use fear, guilt, and shame and manipulation. So there is a difference between request and demand. As I already mentioned, the purpose of nonviolent communication is to build trust and connection, not to create shame and guilt. If you put down the other person, you are not a good friend, you are a bad student, you can't do this, you are hopeless, and then you are putting the other person in a shame mode. You're putting the other person into guilt to get the things done. The primary purpose of nonviolent communication is not to get the things done, but to build a connection. Through that connection, we can go for creative solution. So when we are making a request, we need to make a specific request, which you ask what other person can do. And also you ask in a format that, would you be willing to do that? Even that person say, no, you're not going to stop, you know, stop the relationship with that person. Even the no, you can take it with acceptance and you can find another person, because we believe that there are so many people to meet our one need. Maybe we have a need for love. Are we depending on one person? If one person say no, we'll go to another person. Sometime we might find that one person is not respecting us or not understanding us. So our world do not end there. We find another person who can understand us. Even time to time, we get these problems with our beloved ones also. We might not get understanding, but that is not the end of the world. That is not the end of the relationship even. But we can get understanding from somewhere. Even if nobody respect, nobody understand, at least we can give that respect and understanding to ourselves. So there are so many ways to meet one need. We don't need to depend on our need in one person or even one strategy. There are so many strategies to meet one need. So therefore, when we make a request, if someone is saying a no, we don't have to get angry. We don't have to hate that person, but we can hear, take that no as an invitation. So I'm not going to take more time on doing in any activity here, but when we are doing the role play, you will further understand this component, because we have less than 15 minutes, I think. Okay, so I would like to introduce the NVC tree, or the tree of nonviolent communication. So it looks like more words, but I will try my best to explain in a simple way. So this is a tree. So at the trunk, you can see the heart. It says compassionate connection. So if we take our life as a nonviolent communication tree, the trunk, the core is the compassionate connection. We are communicating with other people with the intention of connecting, not to correct them, not to change them, not to get our things done. But through that connection, we are hoping we are building creative solutions. So the core is the compassionate connection. And time to time, we remind ourselves that I'm going for connection, not to correct that person. So that is the core. At the root level, we call something called self-empathy, or we can call it self-connection. So as a root, okay, now I would like to start from the beginning. Earlier I started, what is communication? So most of the people think that communication is based on the words. If communication is based on the words only, it's very easy. It's not only the choosing the words coming from our mouth. It comes from our whole body and whole energy. So not by correcting the words, we cannot change the communication. We need to change the entire energy within ourselves. Because even we speak nice words, if our intention are different, human beings are very smart, they can catch. Even a children can catch. Or sometimes you can cheat them for a short period, but in a long run, they will get to know your intention. So it's not that we change our words, but we change the energy within ourselves. In order to change the energy within ourselves, we need to do lots of self-connection and self-work. That is the hard part of nonviolent communication. That's what I told, it takes more than 15 years to practice nonviolent communication, because we have learned violent communication for thousands of thousand years. It is in our body. It's not easy to change into nonviolent communication in overnight. So it takes a lot of efforts that we need to do, a lot of self-connection, which is root, the work of connecting the root. And the another one branch you can see empathy, and another branch you can see self-expression. Sometime in our Asian culture, we are taught too much on empathy. Understand other person's feelings, understand other person's feelings, always give importance for others. Sometimes I feel like we are taught too much of empathy. It's not we have a problem with lack of empathy. Sometimes we have a problem with too much of empathy. We also need to balance the empathy with expression. Without the expression, empathy, without the expression, if you have only empathy, then I would say we are like, our communication is differently able. We need both. We need to express our truth and we need to empathize. We need to understand other person's view. At the same time, we need to express ourselves. We need to have the courage to express our truth. So that's what, as a tree, we not only get the water and sun and air from branch from empathy, but also we get the energy, air and water and sunshine from the self-expression also. So all these three, including the trunk, are important. The intention is important. We need to root ourselves and ground ourselves through self-connection. And we need to empathize with the person and we need to express ourselves. So this is the whole picture, but you don't have to worry about this to practice. It takes lots of days and time to practice, but we are going to do a small demo and Bhima.
One thing about empathy. Do you know the word empathy? Is it the same with sympathy? Is it one or two words? Two words. Empathy is not sympathy, right? If someone dies, we say our deepest sympathies. Empathy is, we say, you know, walk a mile with another man's shoes before you judge that person, right? What do you mean by walk on that shoes? It's not giving sympathy. Mostly, empathy is something you feel within you and you trying to understand the other person's feelings and needs. Maybe sometimes empathy, you don't really say anything at all because it's something you connect with. It's not like we don't, ohma tamai, karume tamai, oh amatak karan, that's not empathy, right? We just say, yeah, I feel sorry for you. That's not really empathy. It's like, and sometimes someone says something to us, it's like, mata vela thiyena dewal ehuwana owa monawada, right? We say that. We say our story. It's like, okay, let's forget about it. You do this. We start giving that person advices. It's like, okay, tell me what happened after that. We're trying to analyze it. We're trying to dig it. But none of those are empathy. Empathy is you, someone says something to you, you're just trying to connect with that person's feelings and needs. Sometimes you don't express it in words. It's something that it's a gift that we can give to another person, your liveliness, right? And we say different terms for NVC.
heart of communication, empathetic communication, all that. It's all about building this connection with the other person. Heart-to-heart connection. Yeah, so we'll give you a role play of what has happened when we start the session.
Maybe I'll also come down.
Okay, so how do we do self-empathy? As Ramanusha said, it is the most important thing, like that makes us grounded, right? You say self-connection, you know, at the root. Without understanding our feelings and needs, we cannot really understand the other person's feelings and need. If something happens to me, okay, what's really happening within me? Okay? The scenario in the morning. Ramanusha didn't give her 2 pages. Okay? So if I am a person who practices NVC, this is how I do my self-empathy. So this will happen silently, but for you to understand, I'll express it, okay? The observation. Ramanusha promised me last Monday that she will give her 2 pages yesterday. I haven't received it. This is the observation, okay? When it happens, I feel angry, sad, disappointed. This is my feeling. And what is the need that is not being met? Support and her friendship. And it's a group assignment, right? Yeah. So I am doing a self request to myself now. My need for friendship and support didn't meet. Now I'm feeling sad and angry and disappointed. I am going to go to Ramanusha and say this to her and ask her support to submit the assignment today. So this is the self-empathy process within me. Okay. Now I'm going to Ramanusha because the request I made to myself that I will go and talk to Ramanusha and express all this. Okay. So now I'm going to Ramanusha.
So now self-expression.
Yeah. This is self-expression. Hi, Ramanusha.
Hi, Vima.
I actually sent a message to you yesterday. Last Monday, you promised that you will give your 2 pages to submit the group assignment. It is due on due today. We have to submit it by 3 o'clock. And you didn't reply my text. I'm actually feeling sad and disappointed. I value our friendship. Can you support us to submit this today? Will you be able to do your 2 pages and give it to me before 3 o'clock?
Yes, Vima, I'm really feeling guilty that because I was, you know, studying for the exam, and if I got this reminder like 3 days ago, I would have done. And I could not be able to do that. Okay, I can do that, but I'm also guilty. And also, I wish you would have told me this 3-4 days ago, I think.
Oh, you had exam early. Yeah, yes. I didn't know that. Mm. Will you be able to do it before 3 o'clock today?
Yes. And thanks for telling that you value my friendship, because I'm also nervous that, you know, you might get angry with me with this. And, you know, I'm also a little bit, you know, I also procrastinate things. And at the end, I also don't do things, you know.
Yeah, all of us. Thank you. Can we do this? No? Okay, so this is how it's done. You know, you connect with your feelings and needs, and you're trying to connect with the other person's feelings and needs. And even when Ramanusha said no, when you make a request, you are willing to accept the no as well. Okay, that is the beauty of a request. You make space within you to hear the no from the other person. That is why it's different from a demand. If we put responsibility, fear, shame, it is not a request. Even though you say it in nice words, it won't be a request. For example, if I say, apart from saying what I said earlier, if I say, Ramanusha, I know that you always work on time. You submit your personal assignments on time. Can you do it? So I am putting a responsibility on her, playing the good girl. So we say nice words, but those are not requests. Those are demands. Okay? So if you put responsibility, shame, and fear onto someone, even if you say it is nice words, nicest words, it won't be a request. How come it become a request is you say your feelings and needs with your observation and make a request. That is how it's become a request. With the time we have, so this is like a basic introduction to NVC.
I'm going to play a song.
Yes. If you have any questions, now think about it and also listen to this.
So we have some reflective questions also. So before that, I would like to play a song. So this is sung by Marshall himself. Actually, he's a terrible singer, but I just want to play that song. This is one of his favorite songs, See Me Beautiful. So See Me Beautiful means that we ask other people that see me beautiful. And then when even other people are blaming us or even talk in a difficult language, even though they speak a so-called jackal language, even we try to see them beautiful also, because we believe that all human beings have same feelings and needs, and we all are struggling how to communicate and how to connect. So this song means that only. So I just wanted a 1 minute song. And he's Marshall, who created this wonderful process of nonviolent communication. Is there a volume?
This is what the children at home are saying to you when they say no. This is what the other person is saying to you. This is what they're singing when they say, the problem with you is, if you have giraffe ears on, here's what you hear going on inside that person. They're singing this song. See me beautiful, look for the best in me. That's what I really am. And all I wanna be, it may take some time, it may be hard to find, but see me beautiful. See me beautiful each and every day. Could you take a chance? Could you find a way to see me shining through in everything I do, and see me beautiful? This is what the other person.
So this is the song, See Me Beautiful. Like he says that even people speak difficult language, what they are crying is see me beautiful. And it may take some time. It may hard to find also. It takes a lot of time. But that is the path we are taking.
And today we got to know NVC. Of course, we're going to practice NVC with people who don't know anything about NVC. Right? So that's the challenge. And as we mentioned earlier, self-connection. to build this connection with the other person, we really need to know what's happening within me, my feelings and needs. Knowing about my feelings and needs give me opportunity to understand the other person in a much more, you know, easy way, better way. So we invite all of you to start really doing the difference between observation and evaluation. Nirikshane nigamane wen karagan. The difference between my feelings and thoughts. Ape situili saha hangi mathara wenasa. The difference between my needs and strategies. Avashyata saha kramaveda athara wenasa. And the request and the demand. Karunika illimai vidhanathmaka illimai. When you communicate with the other person, having that awareness, am I really saying an observation that we can agree on, or am I saying an evaluation that we have different ideas about? Okay. Having that awareness really make a difference in how we communicate with the other person. As we mentioned, connection leads us to better solutions.
Yes, and I just want a little more about Marshall. You saw him with, you know, guitar. And with his guitar, he was sharing about nonviolent communication those days, like around 60, 70 countries, including Sri Lanka. He came in 1998, I think. And now he shared NVC in many other countries. Even the countries went through a lot of conflicts and violence also, and now NVC is being practiced in 160 countries and in different fields, in education, in conflict resolution, in peace building, and in psychology and education, and even in business also. So this is for your reflection. So this nonviolent communication, you can practice for your inner peace, you can practice at interpersonal level issues, and you can practice at, you know, intergroup issues, or even at national and international level also. So there are some questions for your reflection. Inner peace, what are the things you do to create or maintain your inner peace? How do you speak to yourself? Do you speak in a way to build inner peace, or do you speak in a way to with a self-hate or self-love? How often during the day are you in touch with your feelings and needs? Interpersonal peace. How do you handle conflicts with other persons? Do you guess the feelings and needs of other person? Do you express what you are feeling and needs to others? So other one is for social peace. Are you ready to choose forgiveness over revenge? Are you willing to accept difference and find ways still cooperate? Are you willing to listen deeply and understand other group? How can you train your skill in doing so? So these are some questions for your reflection. So what we gave today is a very, very small taste of nonviolent communication and some insights. Don't try to understand all the components and don't try to apply the entire NVC tree. Whatever you understood, just practice. Whatever the insights, whatever the aha moments you got, whatever touched your heart, just go ahead with that. And we would like to hear 2-3 voices and we conclude this, and we can go for lunch, I think. 2 voices, I think.
Yeah. One from this side. Anything that stood out for you? Even if you don't understand anything, you can say that.
Whatever moved your heart. If you share, we can conclude and go for lunch.
Yes. 2 voices, please.
I would like to hear. Do you like to share? Who shared the first time? Yeah.
First of all, I want to thank you, the 2 lecturers who did this, and it was really awesome that now I know what's the difference between observation and opinion. Up to the date, I was like giving opinions, and all others are also giving the opinions, what they are seeing on it. When it comes to judgmental case, I think each one of us are very judgmental when it comes to any scenario. So like when you take as an example, the people always tell me that I'm late and you are doing so many things, and like, so actually then they are developing a different story regarding that, why I'm late, and it's just their opinion and they didn't even see anything regarding it. They are just observing that I'm coming out late, and but they build a different story and tell that this person has gone to like. So now I know, I think that each and every one of us get an idea what's the difference. And that even that activity that we did, it was very smooth, that how our feelings went to one another. We were happy at once, and then at the next moment, just because of some small incident, we were very sad. So I really felt that flow of feelings, that like, day-to-day life, it's always happening to us. But today I felt that it's actually happening inside our mind, and everything we do afterwards just depend on that thing. So when it comes to the inner peace, the only inner peace that I got to know is from, as I know, the Kung Fu Panda, like he's doing some inner peace thing. But now I know the inner peace is like this, like when it comes to non-violent communication, we should have the peace. People always talk about peace, that there's negative peace, positive peace, whatever. But still, inside their mind, there's no any kind of a peace. So I think the NVC, the concept of nonviolent communication, is a must for us as cadets and future servicemen. I think from today onwards, it's really good if we can practice this one. So once again, I really thank you, for two of you, for doing this lecture. And that's my idea on it.
One more sharing. I think we are already out of time. Very quick sharing. This side.
On its simplest words, I would just say that we couldn't have find a better time to discuss about this topic, because we are in the peak of assignments. So we all can relate to this so much. And one thing that I think we all can relate to is that we learn to unlearn a lot of things. So that was my main takeaway. And with that, much appreciation goes to all our panelists today, and couldn't have found, as I said before, a better time to discuss this. So thanks a lot for that.
Thank you, both of you. You can actually Google NVC and read anything that you find interesting. Ara kiyana wage ada pansil haragena heta rahat wenna. Okay, so it's a practice, a sort of a spiritual practice. If you start slowly, you will, you know, get better doing it. Thank you.